Hello, welcome back. So now in this part, we will understand another theorem, which is called the parallel axis theorem. Well, this theorem is very important when in determining the moment of inertia of any shape or any irregular body. So what is parallel axis theorem and what is the formulation? What is the formula that we generally use using this theorem? So first of all, we will see what is the formula and then later we will see what is the how do we prove it. So for example, if there is an area and the CG or centroid of this area is say this one. Now for example, if I have to rotate this whole area about any axis, say axis this one, say this is axis ZZ. For example, if I have to rotate this body, this area about Z X axis. So this will rotate like this. Now, as you can see, this axis is not passing through the centroid of this body. So how do we find out moment of inertia in that case? So what we do is first, we draw a parallel axis along the centroid of the area. So in this case, Z axis will be parallel to say this axis. So this axis is passing through the centroid of this area. Say I'm naming this as say Y axis. For example, I'm naming this as Y axis, which is passing through the centroid of this area. So first thing that we are supposed to find out, to find out moment of inertia of this area about Z axis is first to consider a parallel axis which is parallel to Z axis. Okay. The second parameter which we are required to find out is the distance between the parallel axis and the axis about which we are supposed to find out moment of inertia. So second thing that we are required to find out is this distance. Say for example, this distance is say D. Third parameter is to find out the area. Find out the area, the whole area of the body of which we are finding the moment of inertia. So the area of this figure can be say integral of dA. So that can be the area. So in this case, what we are supposed to do is, or we simply write this as area A. So the moment of inertia of this area about Z axis can be written as IZZ. I is used for moment of inertia and ZZ means moment of inertia about ZZ axis. Now it will be basically the sum of moment of inertia about the centroid. So for example, I am writing this as IY, but I am making a bar. So this bar represent that moment of inertia about the centroidal Y axis. Okay. So I bar plus the product of area and the distance between parallel axis passing through the centroid and the axis about which we are supposed to find out the moment of inertia. So that distance is D. So this will be the product of area and square of the distance. So this distance should be the square. So this is the formula as per parallel axis theorem for this area, if we are required to find out about Z axis. Similarly, if I have to find out moment of inertia of this area about say this axis is AA. So again, the first thing that we are required to do is draw a parallel axis passing through the centroid of area, which is parallel to the area, the axis about which we are required to find out the moment of inertia. So this time we are required to find out moment of inertia about AA. So for that, we will draw a parallel axis passing through the centroid of this body. And again, I'm naming this as say X. And this time the distance between these two, say I'm naming this as H. So this time moment of inertia according to parallel axis theorem will be IAA is equals to I bar. Bar means moment of inertia of the area about its centroidal axis. Now see, this centroidal axis is say x-axis, so I'm writing this here as x-axis, plus the area into the distance between the parallel axis passing through the centroid and the axis about which we are required to find out moment of inertia. So this time this distance is h. So that becomes the formula of determining moment of inertia of this area about axis AA. So this is the formulation for parallel axis theorem of the area. Now we will see how we can prove it. So parallel axis theorem is very important theorem, and it will be generally used. We will be using it in solving some example. So as here, the parallel axis theorem can be used to find the moment of inertia of an area about any axis that is parallel to an axis passing through the centroid and about which the moment of inertia is known. So the condition is that the moment of inertia about CG, about the CG, it should be known beforehand, before solving the theorem, before solving the moment of inertia for any unknown axis. We are required to know what will be the moment of inertia of axis passing through the centroid of the body. So this is another requirement for this. Now, if we try to prove it, how parallel axis theorem can be formulated. So here, if we take an example of again an area, an irregular area, and in this case, if we want to find out moment of inertia about this axis, so you can see this axis is unknown axis and it is not passing through the centroid. So this time we will have a parallel axis passing through the centroid of area, say this x dash dash. So here what we will do is we will first take an element and we will try to find out moment of inertia of this element dA about x-axis. So what will happen? So first of all, we are required to find out the distance of centroid of this dA. It will have its individual centroid. So distance from this x-axis and further from this x-axis, it will be y dash plus dy. So the total distance between this axis and this axis, it will be y dash plus dy. So the moment of inertia of this simple, is this small element, if I write this as dix. So dix is the moment of inertia of the small element about x-axis. So this can be written as y dash plus dy square into dA. So that is our simple formula to find out the moment of inertia that I have used in previous part also. That moment of inertia formulation is y square into dA for a elemental area. So this time this y is the perpendicular distance, but this time this perpendicular distance becomes y dash plus dy, because we are required to find out moment of inertia about x-axis. So the total perpendicular distance from this is y dash plus dy. So that is why y is replaced here as y dash plus dy square into dA. So that becomes moment of inertia of the small element, and that is what I have written here. Here it will be added dA. Okay, so that is our formulation for this simple area. Now if I want to find out moment of inertia of the whole area about x-axis, in that case what we will be doing is we will integrate it. Now for the entire area, we can write this as Ix will be integral of a y dash plus dy square into dA. So that becomes the moment of inertia of the whole area about x axis. Now we have to further solve this integration, and before we solving it through integral, we have to elaborate it, y dash plus dy square. So a plus b the whole square, we can apply that formula. So it can be further written this as, we can write this as like this. So y square plus dy square plus 2y dash dy. So that is what I have done here. So further elaborating it, we can write this as a y dash square plus dy square plus 2y dash dy into dA. Now it can be further elaborated like this. So therefore, we will be having three integral: integral 1, integral 2, and integral 3. Now, what is the meaning of these integrals that we will try to understand? Now, in this, you can see this is the integral 1, and this is basically the moment of inertia of the whole area about this x-axis, about the CG. So that is the moment of inertia. So I will write this as I x bar. So that is our first integral. This is how we are interpreting it. And now if we talk about the second integral, now this is basically y dash into the elemental area dA. Now as you can see in this area, there can be so many elemental area. Say this is dA, say the second area is this one. There may be so many area. This area is consisting of so many elemental area. Now, if I want to find out, y dash plus dy, this is only the distance of this dA. Now, similarly, if I want to find out distance of this elemental area, similarly distance of this elemental area with reference to x-axis, similarly distance of this elemental area with reference to x-axis, similarly for this area or this area. So there may be so many distances for different elemental area, and that is why we are integrating it. So integration means we are considering all the elemental area by applying the limits. So here, If we try to find out distance, say I am naming this as x1 distance, this is say x2 distance, x3 distance, x4, and elemental name, if I take say a1, a2, a3, a4. So if I want to find out, product of distance and area, so this will becomes like ax1 plus ax2 plus ax3 plus ax4 plus. So ultimately, when I find out this product, it will actually be 0. So therefore, integral of the second integral will actually be 0. Now considering the third integral. Now third integral is basically the integral of total area. dA, integrating the total area, we get A. So ultimately, the formula for Ix, moment of inertia of the whole area about x-axis, which is this unknown axis. So Ix will become Ix bar. Bar means the axis which is parallel to this axis. So this is Ix, say I'm writing this as Ix dash, plus, now this will be zero term. Now we will consider this term. So this is A into dy square. So this is what the formula I have explained in the start of this part, this video. So this is how we can understand all three terms. So this is what I have written here. So the first integral represents the moment of inertia of the area about centroidal axis, and second integral is zero since the x-axis passing through the area centroid. Because as I said, if I take all the elements of this area and if I find out product of that element multiplying the distance, so in that case the product will be zero. So that is why second integral will be zero, third integral will be having total area A, and therefore the final result is this one. So this becomes the moment of inertia of this area about x-axis. Similarly, if I have to find out moment of inertia of this area about y-axis, so in that case the parallel axis theorem, according to parallel axis theorem, the parallel axis will be y dash, which will be passing through the centroid, and this time the distance will become this one, dx. So similarly, we can write moment of inertia for iy as iy bar, which means it is the moment of inertia about centroidal axis, and plus a into dx square. So this becomes moment of inertia for iy. Similarly, if I have to find out moment of inertia about yz axis, so that can also be written like this. So as already known that polar moment of inertia is the sum of moment of inertia, centroidal moment of inertia about x axis and y axis. So on the same line, we can write the moment of inertia of the area about the z axis or the polar axis. So this is how we can use parallel axis theorem in this case. Similarly, if we see what is the procedure of determining moment of inertia, so the procedure is very similar like we have done in the previous lecture. We will integrate, we will use integration in this. So as I written here, in most cases the moment of inertia can be determined using a single integration like we have done in the previous lecture. So the basic procedure to find out moment of inertia of any irregular body is that we have to define the boundary of the area. Now this boundary can be irregular or can be definite. For example, this is the boundary, and the boundary is having equation this y of fx. So this y of fx should be there, then only we will be able to find out moment of inertia of this area. So if I have to find out moment of inertia of this area about x-axis, what I can do is I will be taking differential strip which will be having thickness dy and the length such that it bisect the strip bisect at the point having coordinate x and y. Now x is this distance and y is this distance. So we have to select strip such that first thing we have to see we have to find out moment of inertia about which axis. So parallel to that axis we will be taking a strip, and the thickness of strip will be differential. It may be dy or dx depending on the axis, and the strip should cut on the curve at coordinate x and y. So this is the basic condition to determine the moment of inertia. So as I read right here, the element should be located so that it intersects curve at the arbitrary point having coordinate x and y with reference to x-axis and y-axis. So this is the procedure. We will try to understand, we will see how we find out moment of inertia in the next part. We will take an example. Thank you.